champion. That's your boy, Ric Flair, and the leader and the brain behind the Four Horsemen, Mr. James J. Dillon. J.J.?
Well, what life is all about is the haves and the have-nots, and what you're looking at is the people that have it all. I'm talking about the Four Horsemen. We are the champions of the world. Tully Blanchard, Arn Anderson, the world tag team champions. Ric Flair, the world heavyweight champion. And any way you cut it, everybody else is playing catch-up. I don't care if it's Dusty Rhodes. I don't care if it's Lex Luger, Barry Windham, Sting, the Garvins, the Fantastics, or anybody else that you want to name, right, champ?
Boy, is it great to control the destiny of a sport like the Four Horsemen do. You know, I gotta give it to Luger and Sting and Barry Windham. They stand out here, and brother, they are an awesome sight. In the eyes of athletes around the world, what can you say? Luger and Sting, the greatest bodies around. Barry Windham, 6'7", one of the greatest wrestling technicians I've ever seen. But the bottom line is, they're standing out here like a bunch of kids with no toys. In other words, not one belt amongst them. So for all this greatness, for all these big muscles, for all these boasts and brags, please, guys, for me, produce. You see, I heard Sting say, 10 years ago, there was a young man who, blonde-haired, brash, bold, bragged, and told the world what he'd do. He was making reference, of course, to me.
Yeah.
But the bottom line was, Sting, I have been a heavy hitter in this sport since the day I made up my mind to do it. I walked out here and told Bob Connell 10 years ago I'd be the U.S. champion. And guess what? I was the U.S. champion. The world TV title, the world championship. What I'm trying to tell you three young lions are, go for it, baby, because it's yours for the asking. Woo!
And the powers of pain when we...